joke about all of you, but I hate it when somebody reads my bio. It's very embarrassing. Thank you for that lovely introduction, Umberto, and good evening, everyone. A special good evening to the Consul General of the U.S. and also to the special guests that we have here with us tonight. I can't tell you all how pleased I am to be here with you all today. And I want to start out by saying it's so good to see so many young people in the audience with us here this evening, because you all are absolutely vital to the conversation that we are all having here this evening. You're vital to the conversation about drawing the line. I'm also honored to be here tonight surrounded by so many of you who are working tirelessly every day, day in and day out, to end violence against women. While for some, this conversation is just something that we're having now and today, something that's just captured our attention in this period of time. But for many of you in the room, this conversation is a conversation you've been having for a long time. And so I just want to say thank you to all of you. You are absolutely our unsung heroes. You work hard, day in and day out, to build healthy relationships and a healthy Ontario. So thank you for your hard work. I'd like to start also by recognizing that we are gathering on the traditional territory of many Indigenous peoples going back countless generations. And I want to show my respect for the history and for the ongoing contributions and achievements of Indigenous peoples in Ontario and Canada. You know, this is an important time for all of us. It seems like not a day goes by anymore without some sort of a revelation in the news. It's almost up to the point where I have to say, as the Minister of the Status of Women, there are times when I'm just not entirely sure if I want to turn the television on. It's not that I don't want to face the realities out there, but it's that sometimes the reality is troubling, it's disturbing. And it really means that we all have to take a hard look at ourselves, our society, our community, and where we live. And sometimes that hard look is very revealing. But most importantly, I think, it tells all of us that there's a lot of work still to be done. And so, you know, it's an important time. We began marking 16 days of activism against gender-based violence on Saturday, November 25th. But as I said, this year is different. Gender-based violence and harassment has already been in the news, on social media, and in on conversations every day for weeks. It's an unsettling conversation, a disturbing one. But let's not forget, it's a vital conversation. It's a vital one for all of us to have so that we can talk about how we build a strong future for women and girls in our communities. You know, I have an 18-year-old now. She's away at university. She's in her first year. And so she's quite a distance away from home. And not a day goes by and I don't get up in the morning, I turn on the news and listen to some of the stories, and I wonder about my daughter. And wonder about what kind of a day she's having, and wonder about her safety. And I'm sure that that's something that many of us in this room think about, whether you're an educator in a classroom, looking at those young students that you're talking to, whether you're a young person sitting beside a classmate and may have had a tough conversation with someone you know well, or whether you're just out there like I am, watching the news and thinking about how it affects us. The difficult conversation started by the hashtag MeToo allows people to name their experiences and also to help the world understand. Help the world understand the extent of sexual violence in our society and how terribly harmful it is for survivors, for their families, and for our communities. This is not a crime that just affects one person. This is something that affects all of us. And it is not a woman's issue. It is an issue for all of us, everyone in the room, everyone in the tent, to think about. Because when one person suffers, we're all affected in some way. And so I think that all of us have to do some very deep soul searching about how we can work together to stop the practice of sexual harassment and violence. This conversation gives us an opportunity to have another conversation, a conversation with our young people, our sons and our daughters, to answer their questions, to empower them, and to change the world. We can change the world. For those of you who aren't aware, I came from a place where, when I was growing up, it wasn't a fair society. I grew up under apartheid. And during my lifetime, I have seen the world change. And I've seen that world change, the place I grew up in. So absolutely, we can change the world. And we can change what's happening around us for the better for everyone. It's about changing the world to build healthier, more respectful relationships based on equality. As I mentioned, I'm a parent. I have a son and a daughter, both in university right now. And while as parents we do everything we can every day as our kids are growing up to make sure that they have the right values, that we teach them the important things in life, the reality is that they spend a lot of time away from home. There's only so much we can tackle when they're at home with us. And so they're away from us. They go to school every day, and that conversation continues. And school, as the educators in the room know, and the young people, is where they are learning not just math or English or science, but where they're learning about social behavior, how to interact with each other, how to get along. They learn about relationships, they learn about values, and most importantly, they have the opportunity to learn about respect. Because that's what this is about. So it's important to make sure that educators and students have the tools they need to help young people with their understanding of sexual violence and harassment, and that they know how to recognize it, to teach our kids how to stop it, and what to do if they see it happening. I can tell you that these are conversations when I was growing up were not happening in school. And so it's an important conversation to have. And it teaches our young people that we all have a role to play. So these are absolutely conversations that we all must have. And that's why I'm so pleased to know that White Ribbon has partnered with the education sector to do this important work. White Ribbon is recognized around the world for speaking out, for saying the uncomfortable truths that need to be said, and for acting out against men's violence against women. White Ribbon's message has spread around the world, but it started right here, and that's something we should all be proud of. You recognize the roots of violence, and you recognize that it was important to have a conversation about it. You also said gender inequality for women is harmful, and violent forms of masculinity for men is not the way to go. You said that if men were silent and inactive about this, they would not only perpetuate the problem, but they would be a part of the problem. And so you engaged everybody in this conversation. You know, we are so fortunate to have the help of White Ribbon to create resources that match up with our government's new curriculum. Something you may not know about me is that both of my parents were educators. And so I know how tough it can be in the classroom to teach kids those important lessons that they need to learn, and how busy educators are when they are in the classroom. And so those tools and resources are extremely helpful, because they make all of us come one step closer to be able to change the conversation and to be a part of change that will lead to a solid foundation of equality and respect for all of us. I know you work tirelessly to develop an approach to reach children and youth. Those of us who have kids or work with kids know the conversation and how you speak to kids is a little different, right? And you need to know how to speak to them. The positive messages they need about respect, sexual violence, prevention, consent, and healthy relationships. And it's interesting to me that the word consent has only entered our conversation until recently. It's such an important part of the conversation. It is absolutely going to make a difference. The stuff we're doing in schools make a difference in our schools, in our communities, in the lives of students across the province. This is about building a better future for all of us. And I want you to know we are, our government is, supporting this work as part of our commitment under It's Never Okay, Ontario's action plan to stop sexual violence and harassment. Public education is important, so important when it comes to sexual violence and harassment. Our campaign, Who Will Help?, has been seen by millions of people around the world. It got people talking. It got people having those conversations. It got people to question their behaviors. And most importantly, it changed attitudes. In fact, our research shows 46% of people in Ontario say they are likely to intervene if they witness sexual violence or harassment. That's an increase of 38% from the start of the campaign. It's huge. It shows that public awareness makes a difference, and that's something we should be proud of. So, change is happening. Change that says we will not tolerate sexual violence. Change that says we will not remain silent. And change that says, together. Together, we will break the cycle. By empowering our young people, you're inspiring generational change. You're creating a new path forward for all of us. And so I want to thank you. Thank all of you in the education sector for your leadership, and the students here in this room today for setting strong examples for your peers. I can't wait to meet the recipients tonight of the first Toronto Lion Sexual Violence Prevention Leadership Awards. It's going to be fantastic. So thank you, and thank you for your leadership and the partnership and your strong voices. We need your expertise, we need your strong voices to end violence against women and to encourage and engage men and boys as allies. Together, we will end violence against women and girls. Thank you so much.